show you is this really awesome 18 wallet that I had as a kid. Actually, this one was my brother's. But it's really cool. It's in really good condition, too. But you see Mr. T. You can see that. It's a bit of a glare, but there's Mr. T there on the front of the wallet. And you have the A-Team logo. And there's Mr. T flexing his guns. Mr. T was a pretty big deal back then. You know, me and my brother loved him. He was the man. He was kind of like, Hercules type powerhouse guy of the 80s. And on the show, I don't know what his name was. I think his name was like B.A. Baraka on the show 18, but everyone just knew him as Mr. T. Also, as a kid, I don't know if I remember seeing him in the Rocky movie or in even wrestling, to be honest. I mean, eventually, yes, but originally I just knew him as the A-Team guy. But let's take a look. Well, first, let's look at the outside of the wallet. Let's look at the back here. I don't remember. I remember the A-Team van, the black van. I don't remember the sports car. It certainly doesn't look like something that Mr. T would drive. But the back says Tamar Entertainment Incorporated, Tamar, however you say it, S.O. San Francisco, California, 940820, 1983. Wow, so this is from 1983. Well, at least the copyright is. But yeah, we've had this thing for years. In this condition, but I don't know, could be wrong. It's a really nice thing to have in any retro dudes or dudettes collection. Alright, that was the first item. What else can I show you? Lots of stuff here. Okay, I'll show you this. Interesting, but this is a floppy disk. This is the last one I believe I have in my, well, I found it in my parents' place where I used to have most of my old stuff. But this is probably the last one left from my younger days that I have. And you can see, I don't know if you can see it. You might not be able to see it, but it says Windows 98 start. So I'm guessing this is the Windows 98 boot disk. And if you're totally confused about what this weird contraption is, it's basically a disk, and it has a capacity, I think, of like 1.5 megabytes, something like that. Very low capacity. You can store, like, I think, like half of a JPEG, or like 3 seconds of a song, maybe. I'm exaggerating a bit, but yeah, these are pretty bad. Very unreliable too, like the data gets corrupted so easily. something goes in here and makes the disc spin. I think you get the idea. Pretty interesting part of history that I'm glad is history. Okay, what is next? I'll show you this ancient piece of technology. iPod. I think it's the second generation iPod, although I'm not sure. It's the first MP3 player iPod, and it's capable of playing video too. And it's the 60 gigabyte model. And I think I bought this probably 2010 or something like that, 11, I don't know. I don't remember exactly when I bought it, but see the back there, 60 gigabytes. And the reason I bought it was because I was going on a long trip, and I needed something to play music and to play videos to keep me entertained. And this did the trick. A little overly expensive, but still pretty interesting. This thing was cutting edge, I guess, when it first came out for sure. And it was in a touchscreen, but it had this thing, I can't remember what you call it, but it's kind of like a directional pad with a button in the middle, but to scroll through the song list, you just spin your hand over the thing very lightly. And I didn't know that, so when I went to the Apple store, which by the way, I felt so out of place in that Apple store, but I don't know why. I'm like, and the stores are always packed. I'm like, why are all these people here? I don't get it. But anyway, stores were packed, but like half, most people weren't buying anything. But anyways, so I saw it on display and I'm like, oh, that's cool. And I was trying to scroll through the songs they had, and I was pressing like this, thinking it's up and down, and it wasn't working. And then sometimes the selector would move a little bit. I'm like, how the hell does this work? But I was too embarrassed to ask anybody because I felt so out of touch. So then I looked it up later. I'm like, oh, that's how it works. You just go like this, and the thing scrolls up and down. So it's pretty cool, but completely dated by today's standards. And what else can I say? I think now it doesn't work. Something happened to it. All the songs got corrupted. So I reloaded them on, and then eventually it just doesn't charge anymore. So I think maybe the internal battery is dead. I think you have to bring it to the Apple store to fix. I don't even know if they would fix these old devices. I don't know, but whatever. It is what it is. It served its purpose. It's gonna go to the graveyard. No, I'll keep it for retro purposes, you know. Okay, let's see. What else can I show you? Oh yeah, I will show you this really weird device. This is the soundtrack of New Jack City. Pretty good, really good actually, movie with, who's in it, what's his name, Wesley Snipes, a young Chris Rock, Ice-T, John Nelson, among others. Pretty solid gangster movie, a lot of fun, and the soundtrack is pretty good. Ice-T, of course, Keith Sweat, whatever that is, I don't know what that is, Christopher Williams, Johnny Gill, Two Life Crew, FS Effect Essence, Color Me Bad, Danny Madden, Droop, / Levert, whatever, Queen Latifah, obviously I don't know who half of those guys are, especially Sweet, no I mean Sweat, but anyways, yeah, so good movie, and some good songs. I like the Ice-T song. What was it called? New Jack Hustler or something like that. Good song. This is what a cassette looks like. You know, most of you have never seen such a bizarre device. But yeah, there it is. You just put it in, press play, and you listen to the good audio hiss goodness. The hissy goodness of audio cassette tapes. And you can see the tape in the bottom there. It's a little bit messed up, double-sided, of course. So, anyways, that's the New Jack City audio cassette soundtrack. And, man, I used to have so many audio cassettes in my family, but we got rid of a lot of them, but just another one that survived over the years. There you go. You can see that it's Eddie Grant, and it's called Killer on the Run. Killer on the Rampage. That's it. And you probably know him best for Electric Avenue, the song. Somebody gave me that song a while back. I can't remember who it was, but I think this one was my sister's. But let's look at the track list. Electric Avenue. I Don't Want to Dance. It's All in You. War Party. Funky Rock and Roll. Killer on the Rampage. Too Young to Fall. Latin Love Affair. Another Revolutionary. Drop Baby Drop. And Time Warp. An Electric Avenue long version. Yeah, I remember I listened to this a lot as a kid. I liked it a lot. It's like pop with some reggae and other influences and rock. It's good stuff. I haven't listened to it in ages, but I remember like half of these song listings. So, yeah, Ice, Killer on the Rampage. It's pretty cool. Let's look at the cassette itself. Right, mute, menu, okay, and that's true, but I don't know what capabilities it had. I don't know if that screen was capable of having little games on it or whatever. I don't want to think that it did, it does, but like I said, it wasn't my phone, so I don't know. But man, these buttons are tiny, tiny, tiny little buttons, so if you have small fingers, I'm sorry, if you have big fingers, this is not the phone for you, I don't think. That was the last item for today. My dog is getting restless, so I have a few more items, but I will save it for